You cannot even imagine how good is it to be with you today and share this video about what does it mean to be a parent. I want to give you three things you need to realize, and those three crucial factors will change your perception of parenting. But before I dive into the three important things you need to learn when parenting a child, I want to introduce myself to those of you who joined our community for the first time. My name is Olya Aman, and I'm a writer and a blogger. My passion is helping people to excel their abilities, to outshine their yesterday selves, and be the happiest possible version of themselves. You can find the links to my books in the description down there. And this channel is called Sap Talk. Why so? Because I share stories about people, helpful accounts of life challenges that other people go through and we all can benefit from. Every tip, advice, life hack, and so on I share here is a result of some experience, either personal or the tale I've picked up from a different person. So stay tuned and let me give you the promised goods. The first one. How challenging and rewarding to be a parent is. Every possible color on an emotional spectrum is present in my life. I didn't know how fast and easy one can go from being exhausted to angry and impatient, then right away feel regret and shame from not controlling this flow of emotions. These feelings should end up with laughter and tenderness after all, because raising kids is not easy. And knowing that I'm not the only one who does not always know how to react to screaming and rolling on the floor and how to perceive some bad temper towards other kids in a friend's house, for example. It helps me to strive for more knowledge by listening to the ones that are more experienced. I read the authors who learned a lot on their parenting journey. The second. Parenting is a life exam and you choose to study and pass it when you decide to have a child. This process involves a lot of explorative reading, and not until I got acquainted with the works of Alice Miller and Adam Ganesh and some other pedagogues, psychologists, and teachers, I found answers to some questions crowding in my head. There is no way anyone can predict the future of their kids. You see, you cannot predict to 100% certainty if your tomorrow will turn out to be exact to your plan. But I wanted to make sure I do the best possible choices and make right decisions concerning my kids every day with a goal in my mind to raise not good, you see, which means in parenting language obedient kids, but happy and loving, kind and caring, thoughtful and creative, responsible and confident, independent and fulfilled personalities. 3. Good obedience is not always desirable, and some resistance to parents can be a positive sign. When fear is used, kids do whatever they are told without thinking, just to please and obey adults. These children may become what their parents want them to be and lose themselves on this way. There is a big difference between a child doing something and believing it is the right thing to do, and another kid that is just following the instructions. The first may create independent thinkers, and the second way leads to unpredictable results. Today, this kid is listening to his parents without questioning and does everything he is told immediately, and tomorrow he does the same, but now he listens to someone else, his peers. And these people may not be the lot you'd have picked. If your ultimate desire is to help your children to set and meet their own goals, well, then be prepared to find out that they may make choices and embrace values that aren't the same as yours. It is not easy to keep the big picture in mind and focus on long-term goals rather than on an immediate compliance. We need to consider what our children need rather than just what we are demanding from them. So now I'm going to give you the very thing I've learned on my journey as a mother. But before I go into this last thing, let me encourage you to write down in comments below what is the most important lesson you've learned by being a parent. Is it something your child taught you? Or is it the tip your mother gave you? Engage with me and with your community in comments. I will read every one of them and respond as quickly as it is possible. So now, to the finishing part of my video, what I know about being a mother is the following. Motherhood is a never-ending learning process, and there is no one book to suit every scenario and one rule to follow in each situation. Every family is a different book to write, and every mother and father is an author of a unique kind. Now, to learn how to improve your relationships, or if you are alone, how to find a lifelong partner, and how to be a better parent, you can by simply reading my book, and the link is in the description section of this video. It is such a delight to share some things I know with you and read your thoughtful comments. Keep interacting with me. Share, like, and subscribe. I see you soon.